Hi everyone, I'm Mohini Jory and I'm a junior at Duke. Hearing loss is one of the most prevalent health conditions there is globally, affecting around 466 million people, and it's projected to affect 2.5 billion people by the year 2050. According to the World Health Organization Hearing Health Report, as Dana had mentioned earlier, hearing loss has significant economic impacts. The annual cost globally of unaddressed hearing loss is roughly $980 billion, with productivity loss accounting for around $183 billion and cost to society accounting for around $357 billion. Additionally, of the global population over 60 years old experiences some degree of hearing loss. It would increase global productivity immensely if hearing loss was addressed, as many of these individuals are still employed at the age of 60. Hearing loss as a whole requires more attention and investment than it's receiving now, because it could have an immense impact on the reduction of economic costs as determined by the World Health Organization. 80% of those with disabling hearing loss are currently living in low middle income countries. Why does this matter? Roughly 53% of the global costs from not addressing hearing loss are attributed to low middle income countries alone. In most developing countries, fewer than 1 in 40 people who are in need of hearing interventions have one. Unaddressed hearing loss in these countries can affect speech development and language skills for children, slow progress in school, can affect them obtaining and keeping an occupation, result in social isolation, and contribute significantly to society's economic burden. The overall productivity and well-being of these countries could be improved with research into how to best address hearing loss, as it's been shown that hearing interventions can improve communication in at least 90% of those with hearing loss. This summer, I've been working on developing a model that tracks hearing loss across the lifespan using hearing loss incidence values for different age groups, as well as mortality rates from life tables from the World Health Organization. We've been focusing specifically on three low middle income countries: Chile, India, and Nigeria. We used estimates from the global burden of disease and life table data to track how many people get hearing loss and how many people remain without, while taking into account how many people die in each country in the process. Our next steps include calibrating incidence values being put into the model to match up with what the global burden of disease predicts, and including costs of hearing interventions such as hearing aids and cochlear implants, to see how cost-effective they would be for each specific country. There's still a lot to be done in terms of addressing the problem of hearing loss, but working to document how hearing loss affects individuals of all ages in different socioeconomic settings with this model is one step closer to addressing gaps in hearing healthcare globally by informing health policy. Thank you.